Ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to be taking a brief look at my Dell Latitude 7490. This computer has a Core i5 8-gen processor, Windows 11, 16 gigs of RAM, as you can see. And so that is a quad-core processor. I think it's a bit more efficient than the dual-core I had on my Latitude 7480. And I'm just going to jump right into it. So those are kind of the specs. It has Bluetooth. This is actually a touchscreen computer, which I like. I don't really use it very often, but I got this for a steal of a deal. It has a relatively small hard drive, I will say that. I think we're looking at, 256. So that I may need to upgrade, but obviously it's a solid state. This is a matte display. So this is a 1080p touchscreen display, and it actually has HDR. The viewing angles, I mean, it's good now. Obviously, this is a default Windows picture, and they're very contrasty, and so it looks better in person than it does on camera. The screen is good. I like the screen. If you're watching a movie, like an animated movie or a regular movie, like with people in it, that's not super dark and shifty, it's good. But if you're watching an action movie that has a lot of dark elements and a lot of cuts and stuff, probably not going to be the best. I mean, doing internet stuff, watching YouTube videos, great, great display. And I will say this is lighter than my 7480, and it has a touchscreen. So that's absolutely dope. It's a fast computer. Just the user experience is great. I don't know about editing video on this computer. You know, the keys are very tactile, obviously chiclet style, backlit. The brightness, you know, on the backlighting's good. The brightness on the display is good. I never have to cut it up to full brightness, even when I'm in like a fluorescent-y office setting like this. These buttons are nice. The touchpad is nice. They have a good feel to them. Overall, I mean, I'm kind of biased. I do like the Latitude 700 series look. Obviously, I've got some stuff on this case, but it's a very professional looking case, very solid feeling computer. It's not like an old ThinkPad where you can toss it against the wall from 10 feet away and let it fall 50 feet and it'll survive. That's not a thing. And then this logo doesn't light up, which I really don't care about. And then here's a charger for it. This is an OEM charger. I love the little ring LED on the end. Think that's super, super dope. I accidentally left a charger in an airport and nobody said anything because these chargers are so great. I mean, this is a 65 watt charger. And if you're old like me and you remember what chargers used to be, you have a great appreciation for these things. Ports wise, you know, you have your HDMI, which I love. They didn't try to go too hard. The USB-C, I love, love, love that, because there have been times where I've lost or left my charger with the 700 series, the one I had before, the 7480, and I was able to charge it with like a phone charger, albeit slowly, but you plug it in overnight, you have a full battery till you get back to your charger or buy another one. You know, the bottom's not doing too much. The fan doesn't come on a ton. It's super quiet. This hinge is metal, so it's very solid. It has a plate protecting it. The screen is definitely very solid. Dell makes good computers. I mean, you can't really go wrong. It does have the SD card slot, micro SD card slot. And then it has USB 3 and then the Ethernet. I love that it still has an Ethernet and it still has a headphone jack, along with Bluetooth. So, you know, overall, this is a basic review on a chassis that I like, so I really can't say too much bad about it. We'll say I wouldn't upgrade if I had a 7480. I mean, you're probably going to waste money. I got a killer deal on this thing. So it's a really good laptop. So it's quiet, useful. It's just an efficient laptop. And with it being 14 inches, it's a good size. It's not so big that you feel like you have a whole flat screen in your lap, and it's not so small that you can't, you know, have multiple things open at once. It gets super hot. Again, I think that process is efficient. It probably only uses all four cores if you're doing something crazy.
And now for the drawbacks of this laptop.
But the webcam, it's just HD, you know, 720. So that's not great. It's okay. You know, I have some meetings, some like men's groups I'm a part of, and we use Zoom. It's all right, you know. Most manufacturers use cheap webcams. I mean, it's a very small camera and, you know, can't really fit too much in there. So I get that. 720p is fine. Biggest drawback on this laptop are the speakers. I feel like I've done every update I can. I have the Max Audio installed. The volume on the speakers is like half of what they were in my 7480. And I have no idea why. I've used them plugged in, unplugged. They're just not loud. It's not worth not getting for that reason, because a lot of times you're going to use headphones. And I don't have children and I live alone, so I don't need it to be like a boombox. But still, that's kind of frustrating. Because if you're watching something with a friend, you would really struggle. You probably need to just use Bluetooth or not do it at all. But again, overall, very solid computer, lightweight. I really haven't stressed the battery too much. This was made in 2019, and I imagine I probably get 4 or 5 hours out of this. Again, I don't really, if I'm going somewhere, I'm not sitting in a coffee shop or a library for that long. I will say my old 7480 before I got rid of it was still getting 3+ hours, and it was made in 2017. So these Dell batteries hold up pretty good. Obviously, it's going to be based on usage, but yeah, just an overall great laptop. I would highly recommend it. If you have questions, I may make a second video about it. I know this is super basic. Comment below your complaints, how I'm an idiot, how I just ramble, whatever. And I'll see you all in the next one.